So here we are again with some more friends from Tanzania and some more friends from Kenya. We were speaking before to our participants to the Hackfest from Nigeria and other places, and we're going to go all the way down to the east of Africa to see what our friends in Tanzania and Kenya are doing. Let's start off here with Damas Makweba. Damas, why don't you introduce yourself and explain where you come from?
Sure, thanks. My name is Damas Makweba. I came from Tanzania, basically in Dar es Salaam region. I work for Dar es Salaam Institute of Technology, whereby my primary role is teaching students as an instructor and also coordinating HPC section.
Great. Yeah. So as we know, we've been working together for a long time, and hopefully this isn't the last time we're going to be working with each other. But you guys are new to me, so why don't you introduce yourself for us and for the project?
My name is Dennis Moki. I'm from Egerton University in Kenya, which is the Nakuru County. Yeah, I'm a web and mobile developer, and I was also a student there, though I finished my studies.
Great.
Yeah.
My name is Charles Miruri. I'm also from Egerton University. I'm a web and mobile developer, and also I'm a mobile security analyst for Africa Hackon, which is basically a security platform for guys who like hacking and stuff. Yeah, and we are working with him on the same project.
Okay, so can you tell us a little bit more about Egerton, as we haven't really been working with this university before? What makes it special? Where is it in Kenya?
Egerton is more in the central location, but Nakuru County is in the Rift Valley.
Right.
A little bit off from the central location of Kenya. It's not really in a big town, so it's kind of isolated. But the environment there is quite good for learning, and there's quite a lot of talent from Egerton, which is, I believe, is untapped. And I think opportunities like these are the ones that, you know, give us give you guys the insights of what to expect from there, and
right,
at least now you can see what comes from there.
Yeah, so we actually had a short presentation of what you're working on. Yeah. Why don't you give us a little bit more about details of what the problem is, the things you're trying to develop and solve?
Okay, in Kenya, as we all, like I said in the presentation, there's been a very huge influx of motorcycles, and these are becoming a mess, especially to the road and transport industries. So it's causing a lot of accidents, and these are leading to loss of life,
right,
which is increasing at a very alarming rate. So we thought, why not come up with a system which eliminate, at least reduce the rates of death caused by these motorcycles.
Raise the visibility of the problem.
Yeah, exactly. You know, create some awareness and reduce the rates of death.
Okay. So how do you see this Hackfest kind of helping you, providing technology and methodology? Have you got an idea of how you plan to put together a solution?
Yeah, because, you know, we are trying to cover a very wide area. We are thinking, you know, grid and cloud computing would be best for this project, because it's something that has to be real-time and on the fly. Like, every time you're maneuvering around the country, you're supposed to know, like, this is a dangerous place, I should tread carefully.
Right,
you know?
Right.
And we think this Hackfest is going to help us achieve that.
So you think you're going to get something working within these 2 weeks that we're here?
Absolutely.
Great.
Get something working.
We're going to get a lot of work done.
Yeah.
So Damas, you working here with the Waimea ICT project, right? That's an earth science or climate science project.
Exactly.
Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, actually, Waimea ICT normally is the improving the weather information management in East Africa through ICT tools.
Right.
And particularly this is the project, and the project itself is sponsoring some students under the level of PhD and the master students. These students, they are working on the tools based on the weather research and the forecasting, WRF, and which is the selected tools which is going to be used by Waimea ICT project aspect. So we are thinking that through this Summer Hackfest school, we are expecting to develop the web portal, future gateway, basically for WRF. Specifically
so,
for this Waimea.
So once you've got the portal up and running, who do you think is going to benefit the most from this work that we're doing here?
Yeah, currently we have those students who are sponsored by the Waimea project, and again we have some partnership with other collaborators, I mean from outside the country, outside Tanzania. So I hope that it will benefit them. And also we have the industrial, which is Tanzania based on the weather, TMA.
Right.
So TMA are particularly needed to use the tools.
Okay.
So they
We look forward to having all this work done. As you can see, it is definitely summer here. It's very hot. We're all suffering from the heat.
Okay.
All right.